Today is the seventh day of the Most High's restored seventh year Sabbath. This seventh day of the first month waypoint is the second of the dual dates that his word gives to us for his end-time son of Adam cleansing his sanctuary. The first day of the first month is the other. On this first day of the seventh year Sabbath, the Almighty caused the most prominent of the false shepherds of Israel to go down to the pit to go lie with the rest of the uncircumcised that gave Babylon to the land of the living, slain by the judgment of his sword. The details that testify to him orchestrating this event are discussed in a pair of videos that are called Billy Graham's Just As I Am Filth and the Cleansing of Yahweh's House and You Have Despised the Day of Small Things. Today's second cleansing of his sanctuary waypoint falls on 227 on his servant Satan's calendar. 227 is the day that Yahweh opened the ark's door. This will also be the last day of a year and a month and a day and an hour of the sixth trumpet as a result of Yahweh shortening the 7 days of the hour to 6 days. He has loosed his four messengers of blood that were bound in the great Euphrates River to identify this period of time. I will speak about how the first and the last of these four messengers of blood mark the day that I believe he is going to cause Yellowstone to begin to blow forth in a bit. The day that I am referring to is the 24th day of this first month. There are several reasons for why I believe that this will be the day that he begins to cause Yellowstone to blow forth. First of all, I am positive that he is going to do so in conjunction with a 188-day period of time, even if it is not this one. I say this because there are 188 days that encompasses his three harvest feasts each year on his restored calendar, and at the beginning of him plucking me from your midst and sending me forth, he sent forth five very notable earthquakes in a 188-day earthquake cycle that were spaced between 188 and 189 days apart. The reason for 189 is there are 189 days that encompass this period of time when you add in his Passover memorial. There are 188 days that encompass the 17th day of the 7th month and the 24th day of the 1st month according to the Most High's restored calendar. The 17th day of the 7th month is the 3rd day of his 7-day Feast of Ingathering, aka his Feast of Temporary Dwellings. This was the day that Yahweh caused the ark to rest and he marked his servant Noah. This day was also his servant Elijah's 40th day on his holy mountain that resulted in the vision of Yahweh's small, quiet voice prophecy. This prophecy was for Yahweh holding back the physical aspects of his wrath while he sent forth his small, quiet voice. However, his word tells us that the day of small things will one day come to an end. It was on this 17th day of the 7th month this past year, in the year 5777, that Yahweh marked his end time Elijah by causing me to extend the 7 days of this fall harvest feast to 14 days. His doing so flowed into his end of the summer prophecy and his Revelation chapter 12 virgin in his dual heaven sign and the beginning of him bringing forth Maher Shalal Kushbaz. It did so in an incredible way. In addition to this perfect 188-day match, the Most High marks the 24th day of the first month many, many other ways in the testimony of his word as well. This day will fall on 316 on his servant Satan's calendar. This parallels one of the most taken out of context verses, if not the most taken out of context verse in his word. I'm referring to John 3:16. Those of you that hide behind your misrepresentations of this verse should read on. Two verses later, his only begotten son said the following in John 3:18. He that believes into him is not condemned, but he that does not believe is condemned already because he has not believed into the name of Yahweh's only begotten son. Yahweh's only begotten son plainly clarified in this verse that believing into him is believing into his name, and believing into his name is believing into the name that his father gave to him. The name that his father gave to him is recorded in Revelation chapter 19. Moreover this, His eyes were as a flame of fire, and upon his head were many crowns, and he had a name written that none knew except for his. That which is written is referring to the word of Yahweh's mouth that he had recorded through his servants the prophets and given to us. The name that he gave to his only begotten son is written in the following verse. And he was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the word of Elohim. The key into Yahweh's eternal realm is found in substituting his only begotten son's name in place of Yeshua's references to himself. Therefore, from a third-party perspective, John 3:18 tells us the following. He that believes into the word of Elohim is not condemned, but he that does not believe into the word of Elohim is condemned already, because he has not believed into the name of Yahweh's only begotten son. This substitution tells us that we must believe into the word of Elohim, or else we are condemned. Your failure to believe that Yahweh has sent me proves that you do not really believe into his word, the same word that most of the scattered descendants of Israel claim that you believe. There are 84 days that encompass the first day of the 11th month and the 24th day of the first month. These 84 days parallel the Most High's substitution of the need for his second anointed son to be dead for 84 hours. The first day of the 11th month is the day that he gave us the writings of These Are the Truths, aka the Book of Deuteronomy, through the hand of his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt, that he has now caused to be written upon the whitewashed boulder design of his house through the hand of his end time Moses that he has drawn out from the fouled up waters of the captivity at this time. He has sent his end time Moses, that is also his end time Elijah, to you, turning your fouled up waters into his only begotten son's shed blood. However, you have failed to be drawn out from your fouled up waters in order to be washed in his cleansing waters that he has turned into the word of Elohim shed blood. Today's Son of Adam cleansing waypoint being on 227 is the first of three parallels to his opening the arched door that he has set forth at this time to mark the coming 24th day of the first month. In the last video, he revealed his dual overlapping accounts of the 377 days of his account of the flood. There are a 40-day offset and a 40-day offset and a 33-day offset of these 377 days. The last day of the 40-day offset, therefore the 40-day mirroring of 227, will be on the 17th day of the first month. This is the day that he resurrected his only begotten son from the grave. This is also the day that he caused some uncircumcised of the heart Philistines to trample his altar under their dual feet 2 years ago. When he did so, he sent a massive heart attack upon his second son of his anointing oil. This day is the third day of the 7 days of his spring harvest feast of that which is unleavened. His marking the third day of his dual 7-day harvest feast parallels the third day and the seventh day of his waters of separation and his touching the dead life of an Adam statute. His word testifies to the fact that the naked and the dead lives of Adam are all of you that are not walking behind the word of Elohim, living by every word that Yahweh sent forth from his mouth. His word tells us that if we touch the dead life of an Adam, including if this dead life is ourselves, we must be sprinkled with his waters of separation on the third day and 4 days later on the seventh day, or else we are cut off from being his people. This is reality. You have not been sprinkled with these waters that he has turned into his only begotten son's shed blood, so you remain cut off from being his people. You remain the naked and the dead lives of Adam that decide right from wrong for yourselves. The 227 mirroring of the 33-day offset of his account of the flood is on the 24th day of the first month. The actual 27th day of the second month is a fourth 227 waypoint. These three 227s and a fourth parallels his prophecies that are for three of this or that and a fourth. This third 227 waypoint of these four 27th days of the second month opening of the arch door waypoints, that is on the 24th day of the first month, is also a seventh day that follows 6 days. Yahweh's word tells us that he is going to cause his end time son of Adam's faces to shine before your faces on a seventh day that follows a certain 6-day period of time. The 227 waypoints of these dual offsets of his account of the flood set up a 7-day period of time. The 6 days of them are the 6 days that follow the third day of the feast of that which is unleavened, to keep we marked his only begotten son's resurrection, marked with his only begotten son's resurrection, and my heart attack, and now this 40-day offset of his account of the flood. The third day of these six is on 120 on his restored calendar. He caused his servant Moses to live for 120 years. He caused his servants Moses and Elijah to be upon his holy mountain, Horeb, for a combined total of 120 days and 120 nights. 120 days is 4 months. This 17th day of the first month waypoint will fall on 319 on his servant Satan's calendar. His word also tells us that he is going to raise me up before your faces after 4 months, or after 120 days. Also this, his word in the flesh spoke of there being 4 months and then the harvest comes. 120 days prior to this 309, end of the 227, 40-day mirroring of his account of the flood, was 1109 on his servant Satan's calendar. This day was the 55-year mark of his end-time son of Adam being brought into the world. 55 parallels his Isaiah chapter 55 signature ring that he has put upon my hand per his Haggai chapter 2 prophecy that the following also marks with 120 days. 120 days prior to the end of the 227, 33-day mirroring of his account of the flood, that is on the 24th day of the first month on his restored calendar, was the 24th day of the ninth month. Concerning this day, his word tells us the following in the Man of the Feast, aka Haggai, chapter 2. Yahweh's word came to Haggai a second time on the 24th day of the ninth month, saying, "Speak to Zerubbabel, the head of Judah, saying, I will shake the dual heavens and the earth. I will overthrow the thrones of the kingdoms, and I will destroy the power of the kingdoms of the heathen, and I will overthrow their chariots and those that ride in them, and their horses and their riders will be cast down, each man by his brethren's sword. In that day, says Yahweh of hosts, I will bring my servant Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, says Yahweh, and I will put a signature ring upon him, because I have chosen him, says Yahweh of hosts." It is amazing that Yahweh has caused 4 months prior to the end of the 40-day mirroring of his account of the flood to coincide with the 55-year mark of my life in this manner on his servant Satan's calendar. It is also amazing that he has caused 4 months prior to the end of this 33-day mirroring of his account of the flood to coincide with this 24th day of the ninth month prophecy in this manner on his restored calendar. The sixth day of these 7 days that these dual offsets of his account of the flood mark is the 21st day of his servant Daniel's affliction. This sixth day is the 23rd day of the first month. Here is another huge mark that he has placed upon this coming 24th day of the first month. He marked his servant Noah 110 days after he shut off the waters. 110 days after his servant Daniel's 21st day will be the first delivery point for Maher Shalal Kushbaz and his sister Rachel that his first messenger of blood brought forth. Therefore, there are 110 days that encompass the 24th day of the first month and this first delivery point. Yahweh opened the arch door 220 days after he marked his servant Noah. 220 days after his servant Daniel's 21st day will be the fourth delivery point for Maher Shalal Kushbaz and his sister that his fourth messenger of blood brought forth. Therefore, there are 220 days that encompass the 24th day of the first month and this fourth delivery point. This is beyond amazing. It is indeed as it was in the days of his servant Noah. This fourth delivery point is on 9-3 on his restored calendar. This fast approaching 24th day of the first month will be the 903rd day of the 1,290 days of his servant Daniel's chapter 12 prophecy. For those of you that have scoffed at the Most High sending forth these four messengers of blood, you should consider what he said in the following prophecy in Isaiah chapter 66. Will I break and not bear, says Yahweh? This is referring to him breaking you at the time that he brings forth the man-child of this prophecy, along with his royal family and the remnant. And if I bear, is it closed up, says your Elohim? This is referring to his Isaiah chapter 8 prophetess's womb and the womb of the cradle stone of his altar. The reason why a woman does not have her period when she is pregnant is because her womb is closed up. Yet Yahweh has not closed up this prophetess's womb. This Shulamite continues to have her periods. Perhaps it is a coincidence that he told us that he was not going to close her womb, yet that he was still going to bring forth the man-child Meher Shelal Kushbaz. He ushered in this verse through telling us the following in the previous three verses. Beginning in verse 6, the voice of a roar from the city, and the voice from the palace, Yahweh's voice that will recompense the doings of his enemies. The voice of a roar from the city is referring to the exceedingly great tumult that is going to go forth from your cities in the days that are ahead, which Yahweh begins to break you by desolating your cities to devastation per his other prophecies, like his Isaiah chapter 6 prophecy. In Isaiah chapter 6, he tells us that he is going to desolate your cities to devastation at the time that he begins to open the dual eyes and the dual ears of those of you that he is going to cause to turn back to him. After he told us this, he went into his prophecy that is for him sending forth his holy seed and Meher Shelal Kushbaz at this time. Yahweh's voice that is going forth from his palace at this time is the voice that is speaking to you. It is the voice of Yahweh's word that is upon his servant Zerubbabel. The next verse tells us when he is going to recompense the doings of those of you that live in rebellion to him. Before she travails to bear, and before his cord goes forth and the man-child is delivered. This man-child is clearly referring to Meher Shelal Kushbaz. She is clearly referring to Yahweh's Isaiah chapter 8 prophetess. And then he tells us, who has heard this? Who has seen these things? Will the earth travail in one day, and a heathen nation be born within one stroke? Because Zion will also travail and bear her children. You have not heard this or been able to see these things, because the Most High has put blinders upon your dual eyes, and he has stopped your dual ears. His word says so. He has done so as a result of him honoring your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts. Zion also travailing is not only referring to Yahweh bringing forth this man-child, it is also referring to him bringing forth the other children that he is going to bring forth from his holy seed and from the virgins that he is going to bring to this place. It is also referring to the rest of the planting of the millennium that are going to be delivered from the womb of his altar that he has reared up in our midst at this time upon his holy mountain Zion. He is going to do so through his magnification of his Nazarite vow and his touching the dead life of an Adam statue. Not only do I think that he is going to cause Yellowstone to begin to blow forth on the 188th day that began on the day that he marked his servant Noah on the 17th day of the 7th month, I believe that he might very well begin to do so at 7:34 a.m. The reason why I believe this is because I have spoken that this mark in time might very well be when he causes this eruption to begin, and his Isaiah chapter 59 prophecy tells us the following, beginning in verse 20, and the Redeemer will come to Zion and turn back those of the transgression in Jacob, says Yahweh. Zion is referring to Yahweh's holy mountain and his house and his altar that he has reared up in the midst of the captivity per his Isaiah chapter 19 prophecy. His word clearly testifies to the fact that his end time prophecies that are for Zion are referring to this place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here at this time. And I, this is my covenant, says Yahweh, my spirit that is upon you and my words that I have put in your mouth will not be removed from your mouth, nor from the mouth of your seed, nor from the mouth of your seed's seed, says Yahweh, from henceforth, in other words, from a certain point in time and forever. All indications are that we have come to this point in time. These indications include his chapter 9, end time set of Adam prophecy, that tells us that he is going to begin this great slaughter with his sanctuary. Since he tells us that his end time son of Adam, since he tells his end time son of Adam to cleanse his sanctuary on the first day of the first month, this tells us that he is going to begin this great slaughter on the first day of the first month. And since he tells his end time son of Adam to also cleanse his house on today's seventh day of this first month, I can assure you that it is not a coincidence that he is causing me to send forth this video on this day. Yahweh has funneled his end time timeline into the 24th day of the first month in the manner that he has, because this is the day that his messenger, that was like the sons of Adam, broke through the prince of Persia to come to his servant Daniel with the interpretation of his end time son of Adam vision. Here is the interpretation of this vision, given to us in Daniel chapter 10. Then he said, "Do you know from where I have come to you?" Since verse 16 tells us that this messenger that was speaking to Daniel was like the sons of Adam, this verse tells us, "Do you know from where the one that has been sent to you at this time as the son of Adam has come to you?" At this time, verse 14 tells us that this is referring to at the end of this era of time, referring to one that was going to be sent to us in the image of the son of Adam, will turn back to consume those who are with the prince of Persia. Referring to the image of the son of Adam, will go forth, and behold, a prince will come to you from Greece. Truly, Yahweh your Elohim will declare to you that which is recorded in his scripture of truth. And there is not one that will cease with him in these things except for Michael his prince. This is not complicated. This prophecy gives us the name of the Most High's end time son of Adam. It is Michael. This prophecy tells us that this Michael was going to be sent to us from Greece, clothed in linen and girded with a golden belt, etc., telling us what is recorded in Yahweh's scriptures of truth, and that not one was going to cease, Yahweh, when this happens, except for this Michael, and this has happened. Daniel chapter 12 tells us that this Michael was going to be sent to you at this time to set you free from the captivity of the lies that our Maker gave you over to believe into. This Prince Michael waypoint, being the 24th day of the Most High's restored seventh year Sabbath, parallels the 24 elders that he resurrected on the 14th day of the first month on his Passover memorial at the time that our ancestors had his only begotten son killed. The 14th day of the first month is 10 days prior to the 24th day of this month. His word speaks of me being bound for a final 10-day period of time. He loosed his fourth messenger blood from the great Euphrates River on the 24th day of the 11th month. This is dual months, or 60 days prior to the 24th day of the first month. He orchestrated it to take our ancestors 60 days to come to his holy mountain Horeb, from when he brought them out from Ramesses on the night of the 15th day of this first month. The 24th day of the first month is 153 days from the 21st day of the 8th month. The 21st day of the 8th month was the last day of Jeroboam's profaned feast of the 8th month. It is also the day that he brought his second anointed son into the world according to how he reckoned the days before he set the rotations of the luminaries into their current 29.53059 day on average monthly wobble. 8/21 of this past year was the 40-day mirror of the day that he began to cause the heads of the mountains to pierce through the surface of the waters. 153 parallels Yahweh's 153 great fish prophecy that he sent forth when he caused his only begotten son's disciples to drag 153 great fish to shore, the third and final time that the word of Elohim in the flesh appeared to them. It also parallels the three sets of 51 men, or the 153 men that Ahaziah sent to bring back my predecessor Elijah. The 24th day of the first month will be the 45th day of the second Go Fund His House campaign. His red horse is the 45th president of this great Elohim-like city of America. Gateway caused me to speak that he is going to cause Trump to fill the depository of his house. I spoke this in a video that was called, Yahweh is going to fund his house through his servant Trump. He is going to do so through causing his red horse to gallop into the battle. and he is indeed galloping into it. In a video that was called 11 Days Journey to the Promised Land, Yahweh caused me to speak of a 688-day earthquake. This sixth earthquake was the 6.3 that was caused by North Korea's largest to date nuclear test. Here is what I said in this video. It is quite incredible. In the last video, referring to a video that was called A Yellowstone Caldera Explosive, I said that if Yellowstone did not blow at 7:34 a.m. yesterday morning, that it will blow forth during the coming 11 days or immediately after them anyway. I said Yellowstone did not begin to blow forth yesterday morning. However, the Most High certainly caused some significant things to begin to happen in the hours that led up to yesterday's day of covering. I was referring to the Day of Atonement that is on the 10th day of the 7th month. This day was on 9-3 on his servant Satan's calendar. Selah. And then I said, he sent forth a 4.3 earthquake that was quickly followed by a 5.3 that shook the earth west of Yellowstone's border. And these dual quakes have continued to be followed by a very lengthy series of large aftershocks since then. And then I said, he also caused the dual childlike leaders of America and North Korea to up their war cry to one another by causing North Korea's dictator to play with some very powerful fireworks. This explosion caused a shaking of a 6.3 on the Richter scale. I pointed out that this 6.3 shaking parallels Yahweh's Psalm 63 prophecy that was part of his fulfillment of his small cloud that is like the palm of a man's hand, Elijah, fruitful garden, Psalm chapter 63 prophecy. And then I said, what I spoke about in the last video about yesterday's 7:34 a.m. 188 and one half day waypoint did not nullify Yahweh's 188 and one half day quake cycle. It actually set up a seventh such quake, I said. This 6.3 indeed set up a seventh such quake, and this seventh quake might indeed very well be at Yellowstone and on the 24th day of the first month. And then I said, yesterday's 6.3 shaking was a very, very, very big shaking. I say this because it will bring forth World War III. 63 is three sets of Daniel's 21 days. 84 is four sets of 21 days. Yahweh caused his servant Moses to begin speaking, these are the truths to our ancestors on the, to speak these are the truths to our ancestors on the first day of the 11th month. And in the opening verses of him doing so, his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt spoke of there being 11 days' journey from Horeb to the mountain of the Amorites. In light of this, perhaps it is a coincidence that this video that spoke these things about Yellowstone in it was named 11 Days' Journey to the Promised Land. 11 days prior to the 24th day of the first month was the 13th day of the first month. This was the day that Yahweh caused the king of Persia to give his signature ring to the wicked Haman for the slaughter. Yahweh began to reverse this slaughter 70 days later by causing the king of Persia to put his signature ring upon Mordecai's hand. Mordecai stood up for the children of Yahweh's people, and Yahweh has caused the one whom he calls his great Prince Michael to stand up for the children of his people at this time, for his Daniel chapter 12 prophecy. And I cried out for you to turn back to him to cause him to reverse the death sentence that he has set forth upon you. I have piped, however you have refused to dance to the music. 70 days prior to the 24th day of the first month was the 120th day of my only being able to light one lamp in each of the seven lamps that light his house each night as a result of your stealing from our Maker. Seven lamps times 120 nights is 840. Yahweh's sword speaks of holding this back for a final one half of an hour period of time. He has caused me to speak that this half of an hour of time is referring to 3 1/2 days, or 84 hours. I said earlier that the 84 days that encompass the first day of the 11th month and the 24th day of the first month represent the 84 hours of my being dead upon the wide pathway of Sodom and Egypt. I'm going to make an end of these with this prophecy. There are certainly more of them, and there are many more parallels that tie in with the 24th day of the first month as well. He has certainly marked this day in a very, very, very big way.